Welcome back. You're watching Morning Live. Thank you for choosing to stay with us. A little bit earlier, we crossed to Ayanda, who's in the east of Johannesburg. Let's now go to Bloemfontein, where Ntokwana Natane is standing by with the principal of a high school there. And she started this morning in a first crossing, just kind of laying the scenes for us. Let's go and find out what are some of the challenges and even some of the success stories in that part of South Africa. Ntokwana, good morning. Welcome.
Good morning again, Sam. Yes, I'm standing here with the man in whose hands 800 children will be this year. And this man right by my side is Ntate Mweketsi Chaka. He's the principal of Goratuto High School here in Botshabelo. And I heard him this morning shouting to the kids to get them into the schoolyard by 7 o'clock. And we'll find out from him in a moment what he has been doing well and what his challenges are. Ntate Chaka, when I spoke to you earlier today, you said to me one of your biggest challenges here in Botshabelo is children who are headed by other children in their households. Tell us about that.
Yeah, that is true. Most of the parents who are staying here in our section are going to Bloemfontein to look for work, and they leave behind their children, and those children are heading their families. Now, when it comes to problems that we encounter in schools or challenges that we have in schools, for example, if a learner has not attended school or a learner has not attended any extra classes, then when we have to call a parent, the parent is not there, the parent is in Bloemfontein, then that particular child will be calling someone. Sometimes they call people that they get from the street, telling us as the school that they are related to those people. Then in that way, we are not able to talk to people who are in charge, people who are guardians or people who have authority over those children. That is why in most cases we find that we are not able to get through to these children.
Now, you said you held a meeting here in December when the parents were around to make sure that they understand what you expect of them and how they can help you with the education of their children.
Yeah, we decided that we need to do things differently from what we did last year. That is why on the 14th of December we called all the parents as well as the grade 12 learners. We said that they must come with them so that we can try to highlight to them the problems that we encountered last year. Like, for example, learners did not attend classes. I had to go out using my car to go and collect, to fetch them from their homes. So we said that we need to change the strategy this year. Talk to the parents and try by all means to organize meetings on monthly basis, especially for those learners who have progressed, because we always encounter challenges or problems with regard to those learners.
Now, on the positive, you had two children in the top 100 in the Free State last year, and they were awarded, of course, scholarships to study at universities of their choice. Tell us about your successes.
Yeah, we have teachers who are capable. The fortunate part of Goratuto is that we have most of the grade 12 educators are markers. That is the fortunate part of this school. And they are going out to help other schools. For example, the school in Van Statenstress has been helped by two teachers, the one who is teaching history as well as the one who is teaching geography. So we have teachers who are capable. That is why we say this year we are going to change the situation.
Now, every school comes across the challenge of late applications. How has Goratuto dealt with it?
Yeah, we are still having that problem. What we did is that we took forms to our feeder schools in August so that they can be able to fill in the forms and bring the forms back before the end of the year. But still, there are still parents who came yesterday as well as today asking for registration of their learners. But unfortunately, we have already exceeded the number that we wanted to admit. We wanted to admit 200, but we had to take 259 learners.
More than 800 kids will be in your hands this year. Over 200 of them will be in matric, right in matric this year. How are you going to do it?
Now, the strategy that we have come up with this year is that last year we did not do most differentiated teaching. We taught these learners in one class together with those who have progressed. But this year we said that, especially during extra classes, we'll have to allocate or task those teachers whom we know that they are good to deal with those learners, so that they can leave them to at least level 2 or level 3.
Now, in terms of the kids who are progressed, you said that of the 200 that will write matric this year, more than 100 have been progressed to grade 12. How are you going to ensure that it doesn't affect your pass rate like it did this year? You said it went down from 80 to about 40%.
Yes. Like I've said, we are going to make it a point that we do differentiated teaching. Those who have progressed will be allocated to somehow strong teachers so that they can be able to help them. In that way, we think we'll be able to leave them to at least level 2 so that they can be able to pass.
This means we're off. Hello?
Dakwan Natani, of course, talking to the principal there of the Khurututo High School in Botswabelo in Bloemfontein in the Free State, and kind of just sharing with us some of the challenges he has to face. Okay, let's take an ad break. We're back after this.